I'm going to describe an interactive simulation for an isothermal continuous stir tank reactor in which multiple steady states can exist even though it's isothermal because the rate of reaction is nonlinear. Plotting the red line on the left is the rate of product generation. So that corresponds to how the rate depends on concentration. And then the blue line corresponds to the mass balance, how the material is being removed from the reactor. So you can change the residence time, the figure on the left, when selecting the rate versus concentration. The only thing that can be changed is the residence time. The residence time changes the intersection. So the solutions, if you like, three solutions to the mass balance, only this one and this one is a stable solution. And which of those two solutions goes to depends on what the initial concentration is in the reactor. The feed concentration is 6 mols per liter, but the initial concentration when we select, for example, when we select this, then we can change the initial concentration. We can't change the initial concentration when we selected this button. But when we select concentration versus time, it says we started with this concentration, and as a function of time, it went to this steady state concentration. So we're solving the unsteady state equations to determine which of the solutions is approached in this simulation. And so what I'm going to do is go to the simulation and give you a better idea of this behavior. So here's the interactive simulation, and as we change the residence time, we change the mass balance, the blue line, and notice we can go where we only have one solution, that's at a low concentration of the reactant leaving the reactor, and then here we have three solutions, and then we can go to the case where we have one solution. In this case, a much higher concentration of reactant leaving the reactor. But we're in the three solution regime, and we select, for example, concentration versus time. So what this means is we start and solve the unsteady state equations. We start with a concentration, in this case 6, let's change it. 5, we still approach the same steady state, and as we keep lowering, there's a point where now we approach the other steady state, in this case, almost complete conversion, because the rate of reaction is high enough. And so which steady state we end up at is a function of what our feed concentration is. And we can also look at how the rate changes with time. As we change initial concentration in the reactor, we can see how the rate changes with time, and we go to a high rate in this case, and here we have a much lower rate. You can look at this simulation to give you a better understanding of behavior, and particularly of an unsteady state CSTR.